Good afternoon, everybody. Today we have been marching to demonstrate our commitment to the cause of independence. I enjoyed the walk from the Meadows down here to Prince's Street Gardens. It's a relatively short walk, but you know, our campaign is going to be more like a marathon rather than a short walk. It's a long haul between now and the autumn of 2014. There's a lot of hearts and minds out there, up and down Scotland, hearts and minds to be won for our cause of independence. And whatever the opinion polls say today, if we put our minds to it, if we show the courage, the determination of a long-distance runner, if we've got the stamina to last the pace, then a historic victory will be within our grasp. Make no mistake, it is a great challenge, and our opponents will be trying to trip us up, but we must not stumble. We must show that courage and tenacity, and with that courage and tenacity, we will win through in 2014. Scottish independence, because basically it will mean a better future for the people of Scotland, because it will enable the people of Scotland to shape that future. As some of you all know, I'm a convert to the cause of independence, and my conversion is not based on emotion. It is based on experience. I served a long-term sentence of 26 years at Westminster, followed by a shorter sentence of eight years in the Scottish Parliament. And I have come to the conclusion that Westminster is completely out of touch with Scotland. Parliament responds more positively and more readily to the values, the needs, and the aspirations of the people of Scotland. We can see that in some of the things that our First Minister mentioned. Things like free tuition for our university students. Things like care for the elderly, free prescriptions, things like land reform. The Scottish Parliament has shown that it is far more radical, far more progressive than Westminster. And if the Scottish Parliament and the Scottish Government is capable of running our education service and our national health service, why should it not be responsible for deciding whether or not we have nuclear weapons? Yes. Why should it not be responsible for deciding whether we get involved in illegal wars? Why should it not be responsible on taking decisions as to whether we should allow bankers to ruin our economy?
Yes!
And may I say, finally, that I'm not a nationalist. I realise that many of you are proud to call yourselves a nationalist. I'm not a nationalist. I prefer the term internationalist. I'm not a British, a Scottish nationalist or a British nationalist. I'm an internationalist, and I would like to see an independent Scotland retaining close friendship with our nearest neighbours as equal partners. Yes. And I also want to see Scotland forging stronger relations with other countries throughout the world. That is basically why I believe in independence. I do not see it as an end in itself. I see it as a means of achieving higher standards of social justice here in Scotland, and also allowing the people of Scotland to play a more important part in helping to build a better world. That is our goal. Let's go and let's achieve that historic victory.